Yo, what's going on, guys? Epic Funny Adventures here, and today I'm gonna bring you round two. Yes, I'm not mistaken in it. Wow, my bad. my bad. You guys are not mistaken it. This is indeed round two of the first part of the video. If you haven't seen the first part, I suggest you to go over to my channel, look at that video, leave a like on it, subscribe to me so you can get more videos, funny videos, or even epic videos like this one, and comment telling me how I did. Your comments will let me know exactly how good of content I am creating. But regarding to a couple of updates, so you're probably wondering, Kai, where have you been? You have been out for one whole week with no videos. This is not like you. I can understand like 2-3 days, and understand 4 days, or even a day, or even 5 days, but you've been out for 7, probably the 8 days. That's not good for you. Well, I need to let you guys know. Things been going on, regarding to, household things, Christmas being around the corner and stuff. I've been working on a project. I've been trying to actually decide if I was going to do the give y'all a Christmas type of video, or if I should just give y'all a piece of episode 2 for Christmas. I wanted to do a Christmas video, but I haven't decided if I'm going to do it or not, so don't have high hopes for that, but have high hopes for it. That's what I'm basically saying with that. Let me see. What else I was about to say? Regarding to episode 2, so in case you haven't noticed, I've also been MIA like the last video. I've been in pre-production of episode 2. I was also talking about other things of where my channel is going to go, where it's heading, and where I want this story to actually go. I have a whole bunch of big plans for the Dragon Ball, the Xenoverse Sagas series. I have big plans for it. You know what? Instead of me calling it that, I'm gonna call it Dragon Ball TXS. Let's call it TXS. Dragon Ball TXS. I have big plans for it, and I want you guys to actually stay tuned for it. So this is, I know I said that this is gonna be my last video, or I said before that it was gonna be my last video regarding to episode 1, but I don't want you guys to feel like left out or anything like that regarding to the Xenoverse Sagas and not understanding what episode 2 was talking about. But then again, when you click 2, you're gonna automatically go to 1 because you want to know what happened before. So if you haven't seen 1, go see it. Not gonna talk anymore about episode 1. Episode 1 is done. We're done with that. It's now all about episode 2, 3, 4, all the way up in this first season. So, as far as me being gone, I've been gone because of Dragon Ball, the Xenoverse Sagas, Christmas, and a couple of other things that, things that I've been going through. I've also been taking a break because I felt like I was overworking myself doing these videos. So yeah, one last note before we get into this, because I know y'all like, shut up Kai, get into this video, we came for round 2. Well, regarding to the whole situation of this video, I had the original video. I did have the video, or should I say, I did make the video sometime like last week, probably like a Thursday, Wednesday, probably Friday around that time, Wednesday through Friday. I did make the video, and when I did make the video, I was going to put it out Friday of last week. I'm going to put it out, and go figure, I didn't save the video. So that whole playthrough that I had of me versus, Lord Cardigan. Yeah, that's right. I found out his name was Lord Cardigan. So all of you bastards out there that's laughing at me, saying, yeah, they just said his name in the cutscene and he still pronounced it wrong. What a loser. Well, I'm just going to let you know, you were right. I am a loser. But I'm a loser that kills Lord Carnegie in this game. Now, I had the video, but I didn't say the video. So, the thing about Assassin's Creed Syndicate, you can't just leave Assassin's Creed Syndicate and just redo the whole thing, like go to the story mission and all that. You can't do that, but you can replay the mission. So, I thought that my video was gone. I got a little bummed out about it. Got a little bit in my feels, but I got over it. You know, I'm a guy. I'm gonna get over it. So I got over it because it was a funny video, and I don't think I'm gonna be able to recapture that. But I think I will. I think I will be able to recapture the moments that I did in Assassin's Creed Syndicate. So, as far as it goes with this video, as far as it goes with me, as far as it goes with the mission, I'm going to replay the mission. For you guys, because I know y'all want to know what happened between me and Lord Carnegie. Now, the only problem is, I kind of know what to expect, but I kind of don't, because I kind of forgot. I've been too busy. I kind of forgot what happened, so it might not be as funny, but I do know what to expect, and I do know what to do. So, with that being said, guys, let's begin today's adventure with this video, shall we? Pressing X. Checking for additional content. ... Initializing online services, circle line. Okay, so we last left off with Jacob Fry. I gave y'all some Eevee, now it's a little bit of Jacob. And we on sequence 8, so I think this is the final sequence. I think I'm on the final sequence. I don't know for sure, but we're not going to focus on that. We're going to focus on taking out Lord Carnegie, because he, you know, he looked at me the wrong way. Oh, gosh. Sorry about that. You know, this is kind of live. I dropped my mic. How embarrassing. Y'all probably heard me drop the mic. Like, oh, my gosh, what the heck was that? Yeah, I dropped my mic. Sorry about that. So, yeah. You know, the one thing I hate about Assassin's Creed is when they put you here. They could at least give you some stuff to climb on, but instead you got this. All you can do is run. Run, 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 and see a couple of tips that they put on the screen for you. And hey, it's tiresome because you know what to expect. And it's like, man, these loading screens. Like, what are you going to do just standing there looking at a white screen with a character on the screen? Like, it's pointless. Okay, so we are here in the city once again. Okay, so for all of those that have not seen the first round of this, let me just tell y'all how this is going to go, how this is going to happen, what's going on and all that stuff. So in this playthrough, I will probably be doing more videos like this. Let me know in the comment section below, and I'll let you guys know if I'm going to be doing stuff like this, if you want more videos like this. But, regarding to the whole situation, oh gosh, I almost ran into that train. That would have been something. Yeah, I would have, like, got desynchronized there. But, so I'm just going to get on this little train ride as I talk. So, yeah. Okay, so now as I was saying, gotta detach this. And we're gonna see this part of the cart later. And I'm just gonna shoot this guy. I know this is pretty wrong, but yeah. And now they all probably gonna roll. Oh gosh, there was nobody on there. No cops, though. No. And everybody's just sipping their tea like they didn't hear no gunshots. What the fuck? Okay. Well, in any case, in case y'all don't know, so I made this game harder for myself. I've been doing stuff like this. I did this once before on Assassin's Creed 3, where I play with no map. No square, triangle, circle button, none of that stuff on the screen. The only thing I'm having is, the only thing I have is my weapon list, which is containing my equipment and stuff, so I know where everything is at. And my mission objectives, which is right there. So as far as it goes with, this, it makes the game harder for myself, harder for me because I don't have any mini map, because I won't tell what's a restricted area, what is, what isn't, what I can do, how many enemies I'm dealing with. The only thing I got is my good old fashioned eagle vision. Now that y'all understand the rules of the game, let's get into the, you know, the assassination mission. So as I told you before, I did not. Well, since I leveled up, I can actually get some more stuff. So let's do that. So like I said, regarding to the whole situation, I just beat the mission. I'm probably on the final sequence. I'm actually going to check that out after I get done doing my equipment. But yeah. Okay, so let's see. How am I going to do this? So, firearms. Okay, so it's a little bit... It's not as clean as this pistol, but it does a little bit more damage. Speed, quick shot accuracy. So, I think I'll get it. Then I'll upgrade it. Get a plus one accuracy again. It's called the M1. The M1877. Assuming that, that's how you say it, and not M1877. I'm pretty sure it's the M1877 Lightning. But yeah, so I'm going to use that gun. Damn! Look at the fucking size of that damn thing! Motherfucking take your whole head off! Boy, back in the day, they was packing. It was fucking packing. You know not to run up on nobody with those types of guns. Never know. Never know. Okay. So let's see. Weapons. I think I should upgrade my Kokiri? Kikiri? Whatever it is. Okay. So I can't use some of these weapons. That's something. Okay. So I do need to go to skills. And I got 5 skill points, so that can go to something. Adrenaline. Increase the rate which your health regenerates. I need that. Oh, and we upgraded to level 7, which means I can now get the important stuff. But, sad part, I cannot get this important stuff because, well, I don't have the skill points. But I can try my hardest to you know, do what I need to do, because you know that that's what I do. I do things like this, you know. But let's see. I don't have nothing else for nothing else. I guess I can get this one, since I know this one is one. What a scavenger. You find more common crafting resources from every source. Now, I could get this because it does help me upgrade. You know what? I'm going to spend this last point. I'm going to get it. Okay. So, now that we are level 7, I can now finally, you know, get better weapons such as this. This looks pretty promising. Hopefully, it doesn't cost them. Oh, gosh. Of course. I need 140 gold. How much do I got? 109. So I'm 31 short. I think I'm gonna save my stuff. I could get this. This looks a little bit more promising. I can craft it, but do I want to? Envori and Jade Crane Sword. You know, that kind of reminds me of Devil May Cry. Is it ivory? I'm pretty sure it's ivory. Ivory, ebony and ivory. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's ivory. Ivory and jade. Crane sword. Well, considering the fact that I do get in the fights a lot, I need to kill my opponents quicker. So this might be my only option. I might not be able to upgrade it, but for now, I can do what needs to be done. So I crafted that, just gonna equip that. Oh my god! I gotta get over this. It's okay. We're just gonna have to wait. We're just gonna have to wait, Kai. Okay, but now continue proceeding on what I was originally going to do. Let's see. Progress tracker. Let's see. What's the final sequence? I got 100% synchronization in sequence 1 and 3, almost 2, damn near 4, and 7. I'm surprised I was able to do this much full synchronization with this story. Usually I suck booty when it comes to, not literally, but I usually suck ass when it comes to motherfucking shit like this. Like, usually I don't get the full synchronization, but the fact that I got this much synchronization means that I'm a pretty good assassin. I thought I was bad, but I guess I wasn't. Okay, well, this is the story, so let's go to 7 since we just got done with 7. Is this the final mission? Change of plans. Evie and Henry.
If he plays the center of the Jenkins, 2 penny.
I think that's the bank mission. And what is this the mission? Use Henry distraction twice. Kill the guards using hanging barrels. No, that's the... Which one is it then? Jacob infiltrates the house of... Oh, here it is. This is the one. Assassinate Earl Cardigan. Earl of Cardigan. Do not kill any policemen and do not get detected by any targets. Yeah, this is it. This is it right here. Alright, replaying this memory will make it so unsafe progress will be lost. Are you sure you want to replay his memory? Well, because in the fact that it auto-saves, why not? So, alright, so the final battle between me and Cardigan begins again. I'm going to have to assassinate him, and this time, oh yes, this time I will make sure I save the video, because if I don't save this video, then it's going to turn around and be some BS later. Nobody loves BS. Everybody hates it. Do your dance. Everybody now. Even Jacob Fry. Okay. So I'm going to shut up and let the cutscene play. So I'm going to mute my mic and enjoy the cutscene.
What's this nonsense about needing a password to see Lord Cardigan today?
Relax. I've got it in my pocket.
Look sharp, men. Allow no one past unless I authorize them. Cardigan has gone too far this time. I've a mind to contact Scotland Yard myself.
Come on, gentlemen. I thought us united in opposition against this perfidious law.
Okay, so what you just heard, you just heard Cardigan, and we got the same place that we was last left off in the last video. Assassinate Lord Cardigan. I think I can do this. I have 3 options here, so let's see if I can do it. Okay, so like I said, I still remember some of the stuff and what everything does. I think, you know what? I'm gonna challenge myself. I'm gonna let y'all know what I did in the last video and what I'm gonna do different this video than what I did the first time. Okay, so first of all, regarding to the 3 opportunities that I have to get to Lord Cardigan with ease. The first time I played this, I went for him. I got the password from that target there. I tried to use him, but that failed epically. So I had to use a Voltic Bomb, like the one that you see here. But I had to use the Voltic Bomb to get all my targets away from me, so that way I could turn around and go inside without the cops detecting me, and went to this target here. I'm not going to use the Eagle Vision to actually tell y'all what everything does. Well, actually, you know what? So y'all can see for yourselves. So, if I talk to this guy, the politician, is it the politician? Yeah, I think I'm saying it right. It's politician. But, so if I talk to the politician, when I talk to him, he's going to leave me straight to Lord Cardigan, exactly where he's at. I don't have to use no Eagle Vision. I don't have to like scope him out. I don't have to kill every enemy I come across. I'm gonna have to dodge enemies, but as long as I come across Lord Cardigan, he's gonna lead me directly to that person, and I'm going to know exactly where Cardigan is to assassinate him with ease. Now, that, my friends, or that, as you see, is going to be my last, and I repeat, my last checkpoint that I'm going to go to. So the next one, I got to get down there so I can see him. By the way, if I get quiet, of course you know it's because I'm concentrating, so I can give y'all like an epic show. Now, this guy here, he's going to let me slide past the two police officers that are at the entrance to make me get through with ease without any signs of crap. I'm going to have to assassinate him, but I'm going to have to assassinate him somewhere. I just don't know where. I'll have to find that out when I actually like get inside. I'll find a good place. I'll kill him where nobody can find the body, and so forth and so forth. This may backfire, but my plan is to use him to get inside the building to get to the politician. So that's that target. So, and that guy over there, he has the password. Using this password, I will be able to unlock the door, kill the intended target, and kill Cardigan without him escaping, fleeing, or any type of BS. So, now that you know what all three of the targets do, it's time for me to put all the plan into action. So, first thing I need to do, I need to go to that guy right there. That guy, yes, him right there, down there. And steal that password without any cops being on no, you know, BS. Now, I could kill him, but it says don't kill any policemen, so... How am I going to do this? Okay, so putting on the hood puts me in stealth mode, makes me less detective against polices and targets and stuff. I should change my outfit to something that would let me get detected less frequently, but what type of assassin would I be if I'm not wearing the white? Okay. That didn't work. I guess everything is kind of going smoothly. I just need that guy to turn. That guy right there to turn, and then I'll make my move. Okay, so that went 10 times better than what it was the first time, even though I don't know how the cops didn't see me, but Assassin's Creed logic, right? I don't know why the cops didn't see me, to be completely honest. You would think somebody who... You would be thinking that somebody around here moving around like this, you know, would turn around and be like, oh gosh, it's a guy who's crouching down for no reason. Kill him. He seems suspicious, but I guess not. Okay, so I got the password. The first time I did that, I had to fight against some officers. I had to fight against some cops. As you can see, I did get full synchronization for this mission. I didn't kill any like police officer, but I did have to kill some guys, some bad guys, you know, some enemies, in order to get away. So, like I said, I'm about to make it through the first entrance. I learned my mistake the first time I played through this. First time. Now there should be a haystack like around. I guess not. Okay, I know what to do. I have to literally get to the point where this guy is at. Right when he gets right there. Once he gets right there, only then will I be able to execute plans flawlessly. But I have to make sure that that cop right there, the same one that didn't see me take the password, I gotta make sure that he doesn't be on any bogus stuff. So. Oh, you can't. Oh, okay. So the last time that I played this game, I thought that he would see me because of the fact that you can like look over, the hedge. Like his head was over the hedge, but it's actually not. It looks like it is from here, doesn't it? Oh shit. See, I got detected. I waited too long. My target was on gone to finito. So. But this might actually work to my favor. Because now they're all in one area and I could probably kidnap this guy a little bit faster than I did before. Like I said, the last time I did this video, I did not kidnap him to get inside. I went through an entryway. I would do that again, but I'm challenging myself for you guys, so that way, you know, this video can be interesting and longer, because I know the last one was like 30 minutes, so. Let's see what they do. Oh gosh, now who is this? Maybe he don't see me if I, like, pack myself in the corner. And in case he does, I got my L1 right there at the top of the screen to get me out. Hopefully he doesn't look over here. Okay, cool. He doesn't look over here, so I can do this. You freaking kidding me? Haha, Syndicate, you almost got me there. You almost got me there. Oh, God! He got me! They found me out! Oh, man. He just had to look to his right. Alright, that F this. I'm at the point where if I don't get this, I'm gonna have to go on without it. I'm gonna have to, because the goal here is to not take any damage. This is my goal, not the game's goal, but my goal here is to not take any damage. And... get out of it clean. If I fail this mission, I fail this mission. Of course, I have to upgrade the tool before it can affect anything. But then I already upgraded other weapons. That's the bad part about this. I upgraded other weapons and now... I'm gonna have to. I'm gonna have to, like, skip it. Come on, come on. I know I can do this. Oh god. Yeah. I thought that it would work, but I guess it didn't. Don't kill me. Hey, all them days of playing with Spider Kid paying off. If you guys are into Assassin's Creed, you need to, because going around and being real sneaky like and being an assassin is pretty awesome. Pretty freaking good. Come on, I know I could kidnap this guy. There gotta be like an angle. Let me think of a plan of attack. There are two officers there. It says don't kill any police officers. So that means Jacob had to have kidnapped that guy without getting detected. And then this guy here just keeps going around in a circle. Like, I don't even know what the hell his problem is. Like, he just keeps going around a circle, just. I mean, like, literally. But, let me see. Every time he walks past them, they go real far. And then when he leaves the entrance, they go back into being too together. Would that work? There is a way. There is a plan, but I don't know if it'll work. But there's only one way to find out, right? So, just in case, just so y'all can know what my plan is, my plan of attack is to do not what I did at first. I did that twice in the video. Like, the last video before I saved it, and in this video. Maybe I've been going about this in the wrong way. What if... No, I'm just saying what if. Here. But what if I'm supposed to go this way, circle around, and target him as soon as he walks back in? Hopefully I can make it to that haystack. If I make it to that haystack, that from an eagle, like from a jump, then that means this plan will work. So let's find out. And this plan is looking pretty... Oh! That was close. But then again, I don't think this is a restricted area. It's hard to tell. I don't have no mini map, and I don't want to pull up the big map to tell if this is a restricted area. Hopefully that guy turns around. Come on, man. I don't want to kill a cop. All right, I'm sorry, guys. It's impossible for me to get him. It's impossible for me to use him to get inside. I'm just gonna have to do this manually. I'm sorry, guys. I tried. It just became a epic fail. Get it. I might make a little small mini series called Epic Funny Adventures, Epic Fails. Ever. Recorded in the Assassin's Creed plotline. Okay, so just to let you guys know. Ooh, sorry about that, I was scratching. But just to let you guys know, I use this entrance here to get inside from the first video. As you can see, when I got in here, I could have like just killed them to the side or something, but I think I got an idea. So there should be a guard right here. And I know I could climb on top of this. I use a throwing knife at his head and it should kill him. Okay, and it did. Okay, now all I have to do is talk to that guy before the cop comes in here.
Sergeant Freddie Abeline of Scotland Yard.
Where might this scandalous activity be taking place?
Oh, yes, yes. It's, just this way. Follow me, Sergeant, but discreetly, if you would. One doesn't like to be seen airing a fellow member of Parliament's dirty linen.
What? I'll be very discreet.
That was pretty genius. My kill was like accurate. I killed him and and the guy walked past without even tripping off of the body being there. Because usually when I kill somebody in front of him, he just stops there and stuff. But let's be discreet, shall we? Hopefully he stops. Yeah, he stops. Okay, so I don't have to rush this. Hold on, man. Gonna have to kill him. I'm so glad those two don't see me. They just paying their mind on their conversation. Now, I'm going to kill this guy before those two come here. I know this guy doesn't come any further. Snapped his neck. So glad I did it discreetly. Alright, let's move. Ooh, that was close. I know he was like, wait, what was that? I just saw him. And you're dead. What? He's not dead? Oh well. Come on. I hope that other guy turns around. Please turn 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 around. Guess not. I guess he didn't pay no mind. But there's Cardigan. He led me to Cardigan. So he led me to Cardigan, like I said before, guys. Following the politician, he leads me straight to Cardigan to use that password that I needed. So really kidnapping the policeman, I really didn't have to do that. And I lost my opportunity to actually go because this guy here, who I just killed his best friend, well, apparently he didn't give, you know, two F's about him. So, but you're about to see why I'm about to, you about to see, guys, y'all about to see exactly why I say get Assassin's Creed. It's so discreet. Thank you. Thank you for leading me to Cardigan.
I beg your pardon.
Password.
Balaclava.
Come in.
Ah, Minister Hacker. One moment. Dashed paperwork will be the death of us, what? Give me a stout horse and a saber and I'd have this government running as smoothly as Henley Regatta. But needs must and all that.
Sorry, man. But Assassin's Creed Syndicate.
Now then,
I got one thing to say.
Good God! Who the bloody hell?
Oh, shut up.
I win. So now I'm gonna let the cutscene play on out so you guys can actually, you know, hear what's going on.
Coward! Villain! Alas, that the hero of Balaclava should fall not on the gloried fields of Crimea, but to an assassin's blade in the very halls of power.
Are you finished yet?
Take your bow, knave! For you have managed what no Russian battery, what no Indian tiger could achieve. Claim your trophy, and may you choke on it.
Yes, but do tell me more about Balaclava.
Farewell. Farewell, dear Britannia. Your dawn shall be dimmer that the Earl of Cardigan sees it not. God save the Queen and the 11th Hussars.
What a prick.
Alright, so, y'all just saw the cutscene. Sorry for the echo towards the end of the scene. I wish I could lock it this, but I can't. I don't have the lock picking skill. But, in any case, regarding to the whole situation of what's going on, y'all can't tell me that when he's like, oh, shut up already, and then kill him, that wasn't funny. So, let's see if I can find my way out of here. I think he's gonna come in here. Because he's seeing the dead body. And now to kill him. I could just run. You know what? Forget it. I'm gonna run. And kill everybody I see. I'm not very good at stealth. Like I said in my last video, I'm not very good at stealth. Usually I attack, I get it done, I get it over with, and then I get out. But I only kill when I feel like it needs to be killed. Well, I feel like people, you know, need to be killed. Okay. Now just going beyond that wall, and then we are home free. Let's see if I can get on there. Off the hood. Okay, so that wraps up the assassination. So I got the full synchronization. I completed the challenges. I got the reward. I got EXP, and well, I pretty much did what I needed to do. Thank you guys for staying tuned for this video, hearing me talk at the beginning of the video for the announcements and stuff. I think I'm gonna wrap up the video here because there isn't another cutscene. I'm afraid. I'm sorry. Actually, Actually, no, it was a cutscene, but I don't think it's going to play because this is a synchronization. A story mode event that doesn't replay again. One thing you need to know about Assassin's Creed, when they do something in real life and not in the Animus, they never play it again. They never, ever, ever, ever play it again. And it makes you very, very upset because you like, I want to understand the story, and they don't play it. Like, what type of stuff is that? Yeah. But, yeah, so like I said, I'm going to wrap up the video here. Regarding to the whole situation of this, I just want to say thank you guys for 12 subscribers. I remember when I made my channel, I didn't put up any videos. And when I started putting out videos, thank you all for supporting me. 12 people is still better than one subscriber, because you got people out there that makes all these videos and then they just don't even like them. They just don't even mess with them. So having 12 subscribers means a lot to me. And I want to thank every last one of y'all for liking, subscribing, and commenting on my videos, or anyone who does comment on my videos. As far as ideas for the next video, tomorrow or the next video that I come out with, we might be going back to explore the world of DC again. It's either going to be DC or Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2. It's going to be one or the other. I'm letting you guys know that right now, that it's going to be one or the other. And as far as it goes with what I want to do, sorry about that. I just saw a funny text. My friend just texted me something funny. But yeah, as far as it goes with the next video, it actually might even be Call of Duty, because there's a guy, like I told you in the last video, there's a guy named Ghost Killer. I was thinking about doing videos with him. Actually, not even thinking about doing videos. I want to do videos with him. Mainly because, you know, he's a pretty cool guy. He's chill. His videos, I love his videos. I love his intro, because that intro was booming. If you haven't seen that intro, you need to go over there to that channel and go like and subscribe to him right now. Tell him that Epic Funny Adventures sent you. Tell him that Epic Funny Adventures sent you. Tell him you're there to show him some love. And I hope that you guys stay tuned for my next videos. Also, I hope you guys stay tuned for Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2. I'm going to leave link to other videos in case you want to watch something funny. I'm not going to leave a video to the Xenoverse sagas. If you want to just look at the Xenoverse sagas, just look it up on the search bar. With that being said, guys, my name is Epic Funny Adventures. You can just call me Kai, and I think that pretty much wraps up today's video. If you want more videos like this, like, subscribe, let me know in the comment section below if you want more Assassin's Creed videos or any other type of videos. And that's all for today's adventure. All right, deuces.